Yes, welcome back. So this is our part 2 for seeds and seeds, chapter number 5. So as discussed earlier, I'm going to teach you about the structure of the seed in this plant, in this part, and also the process of germination. We are going to start with the structure of seed. So seed contains mainly of three parts. First is seed coat. So what is seed coat? Seed coat is a protective layer which protects the embryo, the baby plant which is present inside the seed. And it also saves the seeds from any physical damage causing. So it is a safety and protective layer all around the seed which protect it from any kind of external damage. Also, it contains of cotyledons. Now, what are these cotyledons? Cotyledons are the part of the seed which contains food for the baby plant. So, till the baby plant is able to produce food on its own and till the baby plant starts taking the nutrients from the soil once it comes out of the seed, it needs something to grow inside the seed and have that kind of strength to finally come out of the seed. So, whatever food it requires, it takes from cotyledons. Finally, the embryo, the main important part of the seed is embryo baby plant. It grows into a baby plant under favorable conditions. Now, embryo symbolizes the life present inside the seed. This embryo only takes food from the cotyledons. The seed coat is protecting it. And when the embryo is strong enough to face the sunlight and grow into a plant soon, so it comes out of the seed. So this life comes out of the seed, and this life is present inside the embryo, inside a seed. A seed may have one or two cotyledons. Maize, wheat and rice are some example of seed containing one cotyledon, whereas a peanut, bean and gram are some example having seeds with two cotyledons. So I hope you understand the structure of the seeds. Now there is a process involved of plant growing. The process by which a seed grows into a seedling or a baby plant is called germination. So as you can see in the picture properly, that the seed is put into a soil and then a small radical comes out of it, a small kind of plant is coming out of it. And then it grows and grows and grows and becomes finally a baby plant. So seedling is coming out of it and it grows into a baby plant. So what does it require to grow? The very first condition it required is air to breathe. Just like we need oxygen to breathe, they also need air to breathe and grow. Water to soften its seed coat. Okay, so we have learned in the now we learned that seed coat is a safety coat. So water, what does it do? It soften the seed coat, so it get nutrients from the baby. The embryo should get the nutrients from the water, and it absorbs a lot of water and then finally comes out. So, thirdly, it needs warmth and sunlight for its germination. So sunlight provides that kind of warmth to the seed to germinate. It also requires soil to when the seed is put into a soil, the soil also provides it with warmth to grow. Now germination of seed, water also converts the food stored in cotyledons into a soluble form so that it can be absorbed by the embryo. So the food present in the cotyledons can be absorbed when it converted into a soluble form with the help of water. So firstly, the embryo grows downward in the form of a tiny root known as radical. So as you have seen in this picture, a little root in the second part is coming out. So that is known as a radical. So it will go into the soil first and gives birth to a root system. Now what is the work of root system? It spreads into the soil, and when the plant comes out of the ground and started developing a shoot, that time these roots keep it upright. Then it grows upward, forming a tiny shoot known as plumule, which later forms a shoot system of the plant. So you can see in second step you can see the radical, and finally in the fifth step in the fourth step, you can see the plumule coming out and then gives rise to the shoot system. Now, this is a tiny project for you people. You can do it at home. What you can do is you have to plant a seed at your home and see how it grows. So this can be a mustard seed, fenugreek, methi, or any seed of. So this activity can be done by you people at home so that you can see the process or observe the process of germination in front of your eyes. This may take a few days for you people to notice and observe, but it is a very beautiful process to see a plant growing. Now we have learnt that the plants need sunlight, air and water, but apart from that, some plants need a nutrition of different kind to grow. So this is a picture of a pitcher plant. This is a image of a pitcher plant. So these plants which trap and eat insects, even mice, also exist in the nature. The pitcher plant is one such plant. It is found in Australia, Indonesia or Meghalaya in India. It has a pitcher-like shape. What is a pitcher-like shape? A mug-like, a long mug-like shape which hold things. So it has a pitcher-like shape, jug. Pitcher means a jug-like shape, and its mouth is covered with a leaf. So it has a sticky material inside, and it releases a kind of perfume which attracts the insects. And as soon as the insect is between the lid and the mouth of the plant, the pitcher plant closes it, closes the lid, and the insect is gone inside of the plant, and it gets trapped and cannot get out. So this is a clever way which in which a plant hunt. There is also another plant known as Venus flytrap, also trap the insects. So here ends our second part of chapter Seeds and Seeds. I am going to come back with third and the last part of this chapter. In that part, I am going to explain you about the dispersal of seeds, what it is all about. I hope you have understood very well the first and second part of the chapter. See you in part 3.